Hello, it's Jang here, taking a step back in time to 1972 with this Lego catalogue from the UK. This is 100% genuine and original, and I like to share a little bit of experience of going through these old pages and letting you see what was up, what was available from the company, and how they were presenting their products back in time. So I think this is the oldest one of these that I've gone through. I've gone through a bunch of them, and I will continue to do more in the future. As always, I will not be stopping on each page for a long time. If you want to read the full text, go ahead and just hit pause. So 1972, they were pretty strong with Duplo already by this time. I haven't done a lot of research into the history of Duplo myself. Here we get into what we now consider to be the systems stuff. So these are basic sets. Okay, still was called basic, or they were already called basic sets back. Just boxes of random bricks and some additional specialized pieces to allow you to just use your imagination and your own creativity. Of course, they gave some suggestions for things to build, but those were good, and they still have those today. The kind of the equivalent of Technic with the gear system, which mostly just interacted with bricks at that time, but they already had things with holes, and of course they had axles and such. Just a slightly different design than we have today, but they did have motorized stuff even back then. I like those narrow tracks. I'd like to get my hands on some of those, although they are one piece, it looks like, all just rubber, so that would probably disintegrate over time a little bit, but just big old battery boxes. All right, there's some things that look a little bit more familiar. The big cars, so these would be like the creator vehicles, I guess, the larger creator vehicles. And it's funny that some of these are, actually it looks like all of them are pretty much the same sizes as modern city vehicles. Maybe just a little bit off, but very similar, because at that time, as right up into the 90s, normal size for Lego for vehicles was 4 studs wide, and that included regular passenger cars and full-sized trucks, you know, big old commercial trucks. So just a completely different scale at the time. This is a nice little range, and of course minifigures didn't exist at this time. They didn't get the fully articulated minifigures until 1978, and they had just gotten in the non-articulated ones not too many months before that, actually. And here we get some kind of town plan sort of stuff. I believe these were cardboard bases that they used, and then you just put a little plastic base plate on top of that in a few places to actually attach your studded items to. These are nice little town setups, and I didn't even realize they had a conveyor belt back then. That's cool. I thought they've only done one small scale conveyor belt. That is something I would like to get my hands on, because that would still be applicable today. That's something you could still use. Pretty cool. What else do we have here? Hey, trains. All right. All battery operated trains these were, with the blue plastic tracks. No electricity going through them at that time. There's your battery box right there. And this was just intended to be just a push train, because, you know, that's still completely valid to have a train that you have to push around. I mean, I remember those wooden ones, and those are still relatively popular nowadays and very fun for kids. But if you had a little bit more money, you could get the ones with the motor set up. And then Dolls Furniture set, Dolls House Furniture sets. This eventually kind of translated or transformed into the Homemaker series, where they brought in the large figures with the ball joints and such, with the big heads that still worked with this system. So it's just, again, a different scale, but nice levels of detail here. And it looks like a good number of printed pieces, and kind of printed and embossed. I think I have one of these pieces right here on the front. I think it was actually used still in a Lego Classic Space set, and it's really imprinted. You know, it looks like they actually either molded in or kind of melted in the material, so it gives you a 3D effect. And then here we've just got the extra pieces. Look at that, you could get your clear bricks in 2x4 back then. Fences and gates, those are still nice. Flags, cool. I like, ha, lettered bricks. I didn't even realize those existed either. Huh. And then the trees, looks like these were still the trees of the style that they used back when Lego did HO scale stuff. Interesting old stuff. And then we're running out of colored ink, trying to be a little bit more a little Spartan, or just being careful with their money there. I spent a little bit more time on this page here. There are those tracks that I want. Yeah. All right, cool stuff. Lighting brick, and lots of stuff for setting up your electronic items. That's a Lego catalog from 1972, printed in Denmark, right down there. It says it, 1972. It's just cool to go back and see what things were like at a different time. I really appreciate that all of these products are still compatible with what we have today. If you want to say anything about what you've seen in this catalog, please feel free to down in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I'll be talking to you again soon.